Hey, what's up, y'all, and welcome back. I am Van, and y'all are with the LFR family. And if you're not already with the LFR family, I'm going to need for you to hit that subscribe button right now. All right, check this out, guys. Some of my subscribers have been saying that I should check out and shout out to my subscribers. Y'all are freaking dope, man. Dope, man. Y'all are dope. Y'all are vicious. But anyway, one of my subscribers said that I should check out Eminem and Yelawolf. A song called Best Friend. All right, so we about to do a contest reaction to that. I do want to say this is my first listen to Best Friend. And I'm mainly saying that to all the people out there who actually get attitudes with reactors who react to songs they've heard before. Hey, y'all are cool too, but I've never admitted to not listening to anything and doing a reaction. If it's my first listen, I'm going to say so. If I don't say it's my first listen, it's not my first damn listen. But y'all are awesome, man. Leave y'all comments below. Sorry about that. Leave y'all comments below. Let me know what y'all think. And we're going to check this joint out together. All right? I never heard anything from Yelawolf, actually. But let's see how it go. All right? Hold on 1 second. I do want to say though, man, this beat is nice. It sounds like something that somebody could really go in on. Just dig deep and just flow out of control, especially if you got some bars, man. This joint right here is nice. I like it. It sounds like something I can, like if I was a rapper, I'd be up inside a studio vibing out to this joint. All right, let's go. Yelawolf was like a rapper, because when y'all saying at one point that he was a part of the gracious Royce the 5'9", Crooked Eye, Joel Ortiz, Slaughterhouse. He was a part of Slaughterhouse. He's I guess because it's this type of song that he's singing. I guess since everybody's singing nowadays, he's singing too. Anyway, let me play it, man. Let me play it.
Who's on the face? Say, boy, you know that you pay the price. Well, I guess I'll see when I hit that wave. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I hold you nearest. My best friend. Let the trumpets blow with your appearance. I can almost hear it.
This is a positive vibe. All right. Okay. I'm here for it. Let's go.
Yeah. I don't know much about holy Bibles, but I grew up in the Bible Belt. I put my love over born in the night because I got beat with my mama's belt. But I learned from my mistakes. Try hard to respect people for what they believe in.
Whoa! I thought this was a positive song, bro. Hey. Okay. It sounded like he was telling his story. Like, this about me, you know what I mean? You know, tied it up, grew up in a, you know, grew up this type of way. I was a knucklehead kid. I definitely felt my mama's belt because I was a knucklehead kid. I grew up in the Bible Belt. He said, I respect anybody's way of life. I'm thinking that he's talking about, you know, whether you're a Christian, Muslim, you know, you practice Hindu or other, whatever the case may be. I'm thinking that he, you know what I mean? This is going to be some digging deep pause, retrospective type of song. And then he said, man, if you F with me, I'm going to send you up to my best friend. Hey, that's a hell of a twist for this type of vibe, man. Now I can't wait to see what the hell's about to happen. All right, let's go.
Straight up to my best friend, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I hold you nearest, my best friend. Let the trumpets blow with your appearance. I can almost hear it. My best friend, will you wish me hell upon my soul and spirit? Behold these lyrics. I got a best friend. Me when it's drawn by Gandhi, could have gone the other way many times, could have turned Dali, but the llama gotta squash my beats and things seem to be looking decent recently, but don't jinx it. It's like Clint Eastwood looking for peace, though maybe not finna inner the priesthood, but at least should make an attempt to show some remorse and to be some sort of repenter for the people. I've been a minister, not a preacher, but a shit starter.
Whoa, M, calm your ass down, man. I need to try to catch something. If I don't catch nothing, these people gonna be mad at me, bruh. Chill, bro. Let me back this up just a little bit, man. My God.
To be looking decent recently, but don't jinx it. It's like Clint Eastwood looking for peace, though maybe not finna enter the priesthood, but at least should make an attempt to show some remorse and to be some sort of...
Did he say like Clint Eastwood looking for peace? Like the peace that he carried around at the, you know, that, what he used to carry around? The Tres Cinco Siete? The 357? That was Clint Eastwood's gun right there. That 357, boy, that super long six shooter. That joint, the barrel was about this freaking long. Y'all can't even see about that long. Clint Eastwood looking for peace. Okay, hold on.
To be looking decent recently, but don't jinx it. It's like Clint Eastwood looking for peace, though maybe not finna enter the priesthood, but at least should make an attempt to show some remorse and to be some sort of repenter for the people. I've been a minister, not a preacher, but a shit starter and finisher. Inner the mind of a thick skin, but a shit tipper. This patience of mine is thinner than twine is when I get attacked. So I might say something back that might offend you. So if you don't like when I rap, but what I have to say on the mic, then you might wanna act just like quarterbacks and take a fucking hike when I snap, cause I'm a sinner.
If you're not ready for what I'm about to say, man, you might want to act like a quarterback. Take a hike, because I'm a sinner. Get it? When a quarterback say hike, then the sinner passing the ball through his legs. Oh, that's a tough bar, okay. He said you might want to take a hike because I'm a sinner. Okay. All right, let's go.
Have to say on the mic, then you might want to act just like quarterbacks and take a fucking hike when I snap, cause I'm a sinner.
I've got a best friend.
My balls and intestines, and they never been yes men. They gon' tell me when I'm fucking up the minute, I'm ever giving it less than. I'm about to vomit and I can feel it coming, cause failure's something I can barely stomach. Yet I only listen to my guts, I'm unless you're my fucking belly button. Don't tell me, not doing my
best friend.
Who you think I'm talking about? Lift me up when I'm down and out. Still look to him without a doubt, still got a
best friend.
Like he's never been allowed, I'm out. Should've never been allowed, I'm out. Now that I got a higher power, now with a blackout power out.
Hey, let me tell you something, man. This dude done changed the whole vibe of he took it to that level. He was like, okay, man, look, I'm gonna build you up. This Yelawolf talking. Look, man, I'm gonna get it to that point. We're gonna slow walk it. This joint is not a song. This is a movie right here. This is a movie. I really like this joint, man. Cause he built that joint up and, you know, Eminem gonna kirk out. Cause while Yelawolf is inside the booth putting down his smooth rhymes, smooth, he's singing and stuff. am back there writing some meme. And we ain't even almost done yet. Bruh. Okay. All right. Let me shut up. This ain't about to be no daggone 20-minute video. All right.
Like it's never been allowed, I'm now. Should have never been allowed, I'm now. Now that I got a higher power, now with a blackout power, I'm inside. Powerless, but they crowd around. They tame the flock like shepherds. The black sheep, but I'll be the worst thing that these motherfuckers ever heard. When I'm counting out, you be DOA. Don't announce or pronounce you dead when they sound it out. So prepare for a ride when your arch enemy surrounds you now. He's all around you. Not even the doctors at the hospital are gonna shiggy shock you back to life. Is it piggy possible to revive you? That's worth it to dig your guys. Stuff that I'm not gonna do. I'm the Iggy Pop, Puffy Pop. When I walk in the booth, dog on the truth, like Biggie rocking with Tupac in a suit, talking the booth.
Man, this mofo is nasty, boy. He's nasty, man. Any nigga trying to beef with this dude over bars and music is retarded. They either don't give a damn about their career, or they think that beefing with him is going to help their career. How'd that work out for MGK? And MGK had the best verse ever against Eminem. Ever. He had the best back and forth with Eminem ever. And this nigga's career is still not going anywhere rap-wise. Well, you know what? I take that back. Because I don't know. Because this dude Yelawolf been out for a minute, and I'm like, man, who the hell is Yelawolf? But hey, allow me to introduce myself, man. That's Yelawolf, the guy that's beefing with Royce, right? Okay, let's go. I ain't stopping it again. All right, let's go.
Possible to revive you? That's worth it. Dig your guts, dig your stuff, and it's not an option. Stuff that I'm not gonna do. I'm the Iggy Pop, Puffy Pop, when I walk in the booth, talk on the truth like Biggie rocking with Tupac in a suit, talking the proof, dropping the deuce, fill up a syllable clip like a refillable strip cock and a shoot. Who do you think's my clock that I use that I pull from to get my strength up against these haters? And they be waiting at the gate when you get sprayed up, sitting you home straight up to deal with my best friend.
Yeah.
To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I hold you nearest.
Guys, that was Best Friend by Yelawolf featuring Eminem. Yeah, Yelawolf featuring Eminem. Somebody, one of my subscribers, they said that this joint was Yelawolf's song. Because I see why they said it was Yelawolf's song, because Eminem took this joint over, man. Now, did he wash Yelawolf? I wouldn't say he washed him, because two completely different, they both had their own jobs to do. Yelawolf was, his job was to smoothly set it up, and Eminem's job was to take him out. Like, Yelawolf's job was to throw a bomb inside, throw a little dust bomb inside the house, and get everybody to run out the back door. And Eminem's job was to chop them all down. Yam, 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 yam. Bow, 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 bow. And that's exactly what happened. I like that joint, man. That joint definitely passed the contest. And I can see myself playing that again and again. That's what the fuck I mean when I say something passes a contest. It means I can see myself playing the goddamn song over and over again. It don't mean that the song is bad. It just means that I can see myself playing the goddamn thing. That's all, guys. That's all. I know I missed a lot of stuff in this song, man, but please comment below everything that I should have caught. I'll see y'all next time. And if you haven't subscribed already, please do so on your way out the door. I'll see y'all next time. Peace.